You guys read the title right. Marty's selling my bike. Not the H2 though, no. If you thought I was selling the H2, then you're an idiot. I would probably never sell this bike unless I had to for like legal reasons.
No, I'm selling the ZX10. The ZX10, I've had it now for the better part. I've had it for over a year now. I picked it up from WoW for over a year, and I've had it. I've done what I wanted with it, and I want to go faster with a sport bike, so I have my sport bike. I don't need this bike anymore. So I'm going to clean it, obviously, but I'm going to sell it.
Actually, I think I'm trading it at WoW today. I don't know. I'll have to see if I can go work out a deal. But, yeah.
She needs to be cleaned up, but I guess it's the last time you'll see her on the channel.
So a lot of you guys are gonna wonder, why am I selling the ZX10? A lot of people like the ZX10. The thing is, I thought about it this way. I already pay a lot for insurance. That's a lot of money for insurance for that bike, just alone. Because it's a sport bike. On top of that, I have the H2. All my bikes are paid off. I don't owe any money on my motorcycles. So it's just sitting there. I don't ride it because I don't have the urge to. If I wanna go fast, I ride my H2. It's a very fast motorcycle. So which means that I really just wanted the ZX10 for doing like wheelies and hood rat shit, and it's too big for that. I talked about getting a lot of different bikes, and one of them that kept coming to mind, like a GSXR 600 or 750. I know people wouldn't want to see me on a Gixxer, but it was a bike that I thought about a lot. I've ridden a couple of Gixxers now, and they feel great. And as much as I give Gixxers shit, you know, they're fun bikes to ride. But I decided against a Gixxer. Because realistically, I just wanted a bike that I can romp around on and not care about. And as much as I like want to do that with the ZX10, I want to just like not give a fuck about it. It's too nice of a bike, and it makes me want to give a fuck about it. I do give a fuck about it, you know? I like that bike a lot, but it's not what I need, and it's not what I want anymore. And I'm deciding to get rid of it for something a little bit more reasonable. I guess reasonable. Because I have the obscene bike, I have the H2, and I have my cruiser. So I have my super fast sport bike, and I've got my cruiser, and I'm only missing, you know, a handful of genres that I've always wanted, and I figured that I'm gonna go ahead and pull the trigger on one of those. And I rode a lot of new bikes in 2017. There's a lot of bikes that I really liked in 2017. I loved the ZX14 for that power and comfortability. It's hard to beat that. The ZX10 isn't super comfortable, and the H2 is miserable to ride for longer than an hour. It's super harsh, you know, it's for a track, you know, it's a track bike. So it was like, it was super comfortable. You could ride that, the ZX14, for hours. The BMW R9T, I fell in love with that bike. That bike was probably the most pleasurable bike to ride I've ever ridden. It's very hard for me to ride a bike just to enjoy riding a bike nowadays, especially with it being a big part of my job. The bike was comfortable, it was fast, and it looked beautiful, and it was just this like completely different piece of machinery that I had never enjoyed before. It was seriously like the most enjoyable motorcycle to ride I've ever ridden. So if you've been riding for a couple of years and you're looking for something that's fast, looks cool, and that you're comfortable spending a good chunk of money on, that BMW R9T is the bike, because it does kind of do everything, you know? It's got a very strange engine layout. I wasn't totally sold on the boxer or the flat engines. After riding that bike and feeling the power band and how strong that bike was, and sure, it's an outdated design, it's an amazing platform. It's an awesome bike, and I understand why BMW still uses it to this day. Another bike that I really loved that really surprised me was that Suzuki DL1000. I think it was a DL, I think it's a DL. The upright touring that has the same engine as the SV1000s. Absolutely fell in love with that bike too. It's not hard for me to like a bike, but it takes a good bit for me to love a bike, and I absolutely love that bike. But the thing is, I really like the ZX10, but I don't love it. It's a nice bike, it's a very nice bike, but I don't respect for it and care for it the way that I think you probably should with a bike like that. But I don't love it the same way I thought I would, you know? I love my CBR 1000, I really enjoyed that bike. And the ZX10 is better than that CBR 1000 is in every single way. It's faster, it's more comfortable to ride, It's easier to lean into turns. It doesn't fight you the whole way. It's a more balanced feeling. I've ridden them both in the mountains now, and I would take the ZX10 over the CBR any day as far as the way it feels, but, you know, it was missing something that the CBR had, and I'd never felt the same way about it. But I rode a bike this year that I fell in love with, and I'm gonna go get it. You know, I've decided that's what I want, and I decided it a while ago, but I wasn't sure. You know, I was like, I'm gonna wait till I found the right deal, and I found the right deal, and I'm gonna go pick it up today. I'm gonna let you guys guess what it is. I've had a few, not a lot, but a handful of people saying that they noticed that I've been kind of, I guess, showing out more, and I don't want that people to think that's the case. You know, it's not like, I'm not rich. I do well, and I don't want people to think that I'm like showing off, or what would Rice Gum the homosexual say, flexing? I'm not flexing when I share stuff with you guys, because this is, you know, it's like what I want. I have my nice car, because I like it. I would have that regardless if I had YouTube, assuming I could afford it. I would have my truck if I could afford it without YouTube. You know, it's stuff that I enjoy, and I like sharing that stuff with you guys, and I want you guys to understand that I'm not flexing when I get new things. Yeah, I don't feel like I've ever been like, look what I got, herder. I'm just like, dude, I'm fucking excited to do this. And so if I've ever shown that, you know, I apologize. But this is a strange purchase for me because it's obviously a step down. You know, the bike doesn't cost as much as the ZX10. The insurance is cheaper. It's not, it's a nice bike. Don't get me wrong. It's a nice bike. It's just, you know, I would say it's less valuable, you know, than the ZX10 is monetarily wise anyway. Which ultimately is a business decision for me, which is, it's weird to say, I guess. I think people enjoy the videos more if I get this bike, which isn't the only reason I'm getting it. I had tons of fun the last time I rode one of these, and I'm making you wait for the reveal. Because that's how I am. I'm a dickhead. All right, so not only did I sell the new bike today, I got the new bike today, and I will reveal it in the next video. You guys will see a regular video of it, and I'll let you guys know more about the ZX10 in the future. Oh shit, I forgot I need gas. I'm sure there's gonna be someone who wants to buy it, so I'll let you guys know about who has it soon and see if you guys want it. So yeah, I'm pretty freaking stoked about this, man.